Hello, everyone. So I kind of misunderstood the assignment and didn't bring in an image that inspired me. Instead, I brought in an image from a project that I do, but I'm going to talk about why I was so excited to do this project. And while I do that, I'm going to pass out, this is essentially our business card. So feel free to take one of these and pass it around. So what I'm showing you here is an image of an event that we staged in Portland, Maine, as part of a project that I run called the Institute for American Art. It functions as a museum. It has a social presence as a museum. We like to think that we put our educational strategies at the forefront in keeping with some normal museological standards. And 4 years ago, the project was launched in the parlor of my apartment, and we have been running the project, my husband and I, for the last 4 years, intermittently in our house, but also where this was staged, which was an unused corporate office space in downtown Portland, Maine. And a lot of people, when they approach showing contemporary artwork, they approach it kind of privileging the experience of seeing a work of contemporary art. And the reason why I wanted to show this specific image is because I actually came to showing artwork with a much more, I was much more interested in how a kind of the environment of a movie theater functioned as a social zone. Everyone would come into the same space, the lights would be dimmed, you would experience culture, and you were kind of left when the lights came up to your own devices. And it was very, community-based, but very independent and individuated, and I really appreciated that. And at a certain point in the development of this project, I became really, really, really interested in Piero Paolo Pasolini, excuse me, full name, kind of irreverent 70s filmmaker from Italy, and I wanted to show a Pasolini movie because I live in Portland, Maine, and there's not that many gay things, there's not that many queer things, and I really knew that his voice was needed in the space, in the city. And I was looking at all of the films that I could show and realized that given the fact that I started a museum in my home, I have no board of directors. And given the fact that I had no board of directors, I have no one to apologize to, and no one's permission to see. And so I immediately went to Saul, or 120 Days of Sodom. And this is a moment where you can see the film being projected, and just imagine yourself seated in the same theater and you would be watching this. And so it was this great moment of like, I'm gonna show the most shocking film to ever come out of film history, quote unquote. And then I was having this conversation with a friend of mine who's a filmmaker named John Fireman, who's kind of based between New York and Portland, and he said, I've got this great idea for a screening series that is called Filmus Interruptus, where it kind of hybridizes the movie theater and the gallery. And I was like, oh my God, that's amazing. That's exactly what I wanted to do. That's kind of where I started this project. And the shape that it took, and you can see Kenneth Rosen here, who's a poet, Kenneth Rosen, right there, and then this human who I don't know. What John Fireman did, is he arranged a group of panelists to essentially sit above the audience. The audience is seated on the floor. He would screen the movie, and the panelists could interrupt the film at any point and say whatever they needed to say. And so one of the panelists was a Pasolini historian, and so really early on, she stopped the film and gave an explanation of why we were seeing fascistic imagery and where it was going to go. And at a certain point, a man who runs a kind of quixotic video store in Portland, Maine, also kind of stopped and said, I don't care about any of the fascist stuff. I like watching this movie when I was a kid because it was the first time I saw sex that I didn't identify with. And that really challenged me as a young sexual person. And then this guy, Kenneth Rosen, who's a poet, you might know his work, he is in quite a lot of publications. he would continually stop this just to make sure that the community was coming together and that people were actually engaging with one another. And at a certain point, this is what this image is of, Rosen just pulls out a piece of paper from his jacket and begins to read a poem that is dedicated to that evening. And I realized something in that situation, that this project that we started, that I had started in my house, had actually developed into this thing that was giving me exactly what I wanted without necessarily seeking it out in really rigid terms. I kind of said out loud what I wanted this thing to be and then just let it go. And at a certain point in this moment, when this person, whose writing I have quite a lot of respect for, refers to my space as a renegade art space. And it also happens, you can't really see this, but the quote up here is charming, do you want my dirty underwear, question mark. So it's this kind of, this image is this fusion of a very, how do I say this? It's not, this scene is not shocking because of all the rest of the scenes in the film. And so there's this kind of like happenstance conversation that's happening here, and this happenstance moment, because we're all kind of in this room enjoying this thing together. And I'm going way off on a tangent right now. I'm kind of losing track of where I started, but essentially what I wanted to talk to you all about was that the idea of running an art museum is one that can really easily be entrenched in institutional criticism. I could have had a lot of different artists up here. I could have had a lot of different artworks up here. And instead, I wanted to shift the focus a little bit and to talk more about kind of what these spaces can become when the use of them is slightly shifted. I mean, we're here, you're all sitting here with your backs to that artwork, listening to me, ignoring this thing, which is quite visually stimulating. And so there's this kind of funny thing that can happen inside of all cultural spaces, whether they're a movie theater or an art gallery. And that is really the impetus for my work in general. I'm also a professor, and so I try and like destabilize the classroom in the same way that I try to destabilize a museum. And all of it is ultimately, though, in good fun, and it's thoughtful and planned out, and much more planned out than this talk is. But it's still very open and fluid to just let it, as a project, follow its own impulses and follow its own accord. And yeah, it's weird to talk it to people without giving them an option of questions. I'm so used to being in the classroom where you guide my conversations. And so, yeah, how much time do I have left?
2 minutes.
Okay. So just to go a little bit more, I don't know if I have much more to say. The little books that I handed out have all of the stuff on, it has the website, which shows you what we do. And the project here was just, it's an itinerant museum is the word that I've been using to describe it. And it's something that, like, in the cheesiest, most like overly, a very dull romantic way of thinking about it is like, we are a flowering plant. Where we show up for a certain period of time and we do a hell of a lot of things, and then at end of that duration we close back up. And so right now we have no public face in Portland, Maine. We have no public face in any place right now other than the internet. And but that is not to say that we are not plotting and planning for what will come next. And that will also always take the form of whatever space we can get, whatever people want to work with us, and however these projects need to take shape. It really is a museum run by the people who want to participate in it, both the audience and the artists, and so, which is a really humbling thing to try and negotiate as somebody who wants to just also show really good work. Sometimes when you give artists the keys to a project space, they're not going to make anything good, and you have to realize like that's kind of fine and that's kind of fun. And this project, we had no idea if it was going to be a success. And then all of a sudden, this guy pulls out that piece of paper, and all of my dreams came true. So,
yeah.
Yeah.